My name is Mike McCray. How you doing today?
I'm doing well, man. How are you?
I'm doing good, man. You know, I'm here. You know, you came to me. You wanted some help, you know, to talk. You know, just want you to know that I'm here for you. And, I'm going to ask you a few questions, you know, and you don't have to answer every question, you know. I'm going to ask some questions that's a little uncomfortable maybe to you. And just to get to know you and your past and what you've been through and things like that.
All right.
How about we start off with your name? Where are you from?
Yeah, I'm D. Laquan, from Memphis, Tennessee. Pretty rough neighborhood, west east side of Memphis. That's about it.
All right, how old are you again?
I'm 17 years old.
All right, tell me a little bit about your past, like what brings you in?
Yeah, basically just coming here, you know, it was an option for me with my probation officer, try to help me with my, you know, my anger issues and anger outbursts and stuff like that. You know, I had a, you know, pretty tough time growing up. I dropped out of school, so that was one reason I was on probation, got in a little trouble. But, you know, dropped out of school, dad passed away, and, you know, it's just me, my mom, and my younger brother, and I got an older brother as well.
All right, sorry to hear about your dad passing away, and how old were you when that happened?
Yeah, man, that was about 3 years ago. My dad got shot about 3 years ago, but
yeah, man, that was tough for you. And so you live with your mom and your little brother, you said?
Yeah, my mom, my little brother, then my older brother, he lived by himself.
All right, how's your relationship with your mom and your younger brother?
We got a pretty good relationship, man. You know, after that happened, it really brought us closer together. As I said before, me and my mom kind of went through a rough patch though when I dropped out of school, because she really didn't want me to drop out, but I looked at it as I really didn't have an option. You know, I was going to school and trying to come home and, you know, help make ends meet, and for a single parent with two kids living in the house, it was pretty hard for my mom, you know. So we had a rough patch during that time, but you know, she eventually realized like I was doing it to help her, and she doesn't always agree with it, but you know, she's thankful for the things that I try to do to help around the house.
All right, you know, you said you dropped out and you worked to help out at home, you know, but other than that, you are a 17-year-old, you know, teenager. So what else do you do other than, you know, work?
Yeah, I mean, I work. I mean, I try to play basketball from time to time. You know, I mentioned I got in a little trouble, so I was selling little drugs, little weed on the side. To, you know, try to help my mom. I wasn't really trying to do it because I was a bad kid who was trying to break the laws, but just trying to help out my mom and my little brother. You know, so I don't think it's that big of a deal, but I smoke weed too, but I'm here because I want to, you know, become level-headed, clear-minded.
Okay, so you're saying, like, since you're father passed away, you know, it kind of hurt you mentally, you know.
For sure.
So you could say that's why, you know, smoke weed to like ease the pain a little bit, maybe.
Yeah, definitely, man. Before he passed away, man, I never was a kid that I didn't smoke or didn't drink, do anything like that, man. But you know, he passed away, and you know, it hurt me, man. I was depressed for a little bit. You know, I dropped out of school, and yeah, man, I just guess when I smoke weed, it just I guess you're right, man. Just ease the pain a little bit, take my mind off of maybe when I'm feeling down, it just take my mind away from it for a little bit, I guess.
All right, you know, you say a little depressed.
Mm-hmm.
What do you do other than, you know, you say you smoke weed when you low down, but other than that, like, what do you do, you know, to help with your depressed state of mind, you can say?
It's really nothing that I normally do for real, because I think that's why I resorted to smoking weed, man, because I really don't try to talk about it with my mom, because she probably don't want to talk about stuff like that, man. That situation hurt her, you know, as a wife, you know, having your husband murdered. I really don't try to bring it up to her as much. So usually when I get depressed, sometimes I get angry, like I said earlier, like I'm here because, you know, my probation officer wanted me to come here to help with my anger and, you know, my drug abuse, I guess. But yeah, I really don't do too much to cope with it besides smoke weed.
Alright, I mean, you said you like, you know, you like playing sports, you know, did you play sports before you dropped out of school?
Yeah, man, I dropped out, or yeah, I did play sports. I was on the basketball team and I ran track. Man, I was actually kind of good, man, at both sports, but, you know, when that situation happened, I had to stop playing sports and, you know, try to help out my mom, but yeah, I did play sports.
You know, what about your friends? You got any friends like that you still talk to from school that kind of help you a little bit, maybe?
Yeah, you know what? I do got some friends, man. Some friends that I grew up with. They, you know, I'm happy for them. They actually in their senior year now in high school and about to graduate soon. So I do have some friends. I don't really talk to them as much as I used to talk to them, because I had to, you know, drop out, and I do, you know, do some things that they, I was doing some things that I got in trouble with that they weren't really doing, but I definitely got some friends that I can talk to.
Okay, what about you said you had an older brother, you know, what's your relationship like with him?
Yeah, his relationship, we pretty close, man, but, you know, I just me agreeing with my probation officer that I should come here, I'm trying to kind of, like, you know, not distance myself, but, you know, create a little space because, you know, my brother was, you know, he kind of helped me to get on with, you know, selling weed a little bit to try to make a little money. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I know that's not the right thing to do, but we close. I just feel like I gotta, you know, create a little space just so I can get on the right path. All
right, I got one question for you. Do you want, you know, or do you want to get better, you know, with like stop smoking weed and like moving on with your life from that?
Yeah, I definitely want to get better, man. I don't feel like the weed is like that big of a deal, but if not smoking weed can help me with my anger and I can find other things to do, if you can help me, you know, to find other things to do when I get depressed or angry, sad or whatever the case may be, when I think about my dad or think about, you know, the life that I could have had if I didn't have to drop out of school, then, you know, I'm definitely open to stop smoking weed and, you know, and just doing the right thing.
You know, you said I can help you find a way, but, you know, I was thinking, you know, you said your mom didn't really want you to drop out of school. Did you ever think about going back to school? Maybe that can help you, you know, cope your mind a little bit, you know, go back to playing sports, you know, going to college, you know, for the sport, and just for that to be like an outlet for you to keep your mind off of things.
Yeah, I definitely want to, but man, I feel like one of the hardest things for me is just, you know, I feel like maybe if I go back to school, I won't be able to make as much money to help my mom, you know, so I definitely thought about going back to school though, but that might be a good idea to help me, you know, keep my mind busy and off of, you know, negative things.
You know, yeah, like I said, you know, I feel like that could help you a lot, you know, keep your mind off of things, you know, it could be a big, big influence, you know, to your younger brother and showing him the right way, you know, to finish school and, hopefully, like you said, you're pretty good at sports, you know, you can go to college for free so your mom doesn't have to worry about, you know, paying for anything, taking care of you like that. And I feel like that's the right step in the direction, you know, to go back to school, you know, and maybe be around your friends, you know. They just help you cope your mind a little bit and, you know, and make things a lot better for you.
Yeah, man, I agree, man. I appreciate you.